Hello children, this video is belong to class 8. So it's the first lesson is representation of geographical features. So outline of the chapters is first one is introduction and second one is interpreting contour on the top sheet, height, shapes, etc. And index contour, type of slope, and third one is feature related to height and elevation of the landscape. Its point, first point is conical hill, watershed ridge, plateau, a cliff, waterfall, and third one is pass, saddle, col, and gap. Fourth point is settlement pattern, and fifth one is conventional signs of settlements pattern. Sixth one is interpretations and analysis of the given top sheet. And seventh one is legend. So, first, introduction. The earth's surface is uneven, made up of hills, plains, plateau, lowland, etc., which are varying in their elevation or height for the sea level. The total terrain is also called physical landscape. It can be represented on the maps through different methods such as spot, heights and contouring, etc. And first point is surveying is considered a part of the science of map making based upon the objective survey. Maps may be archaeological, geological, topographical, cadastral, military or tourist. Since topographical maps are large scale maps, they show a great deal to detail about the relief. And second point is, hence in topographical survey, actually survey is carried out and different methods are used. So representative relief on the map as follows. In first is hachuring, second is hill shading, third is form lines, and fourth is spot heights. And fifth is triangulation point, and sixth is benchmark. Sometimes two of these methods are combined, for example contour and hatchers. Hatchering. Hatcherings are the short lines representing direction of slope. For a steep slope, they are drawn closer together than for the gentle slope. However, on flat ground, they cannot be used at all. You can see over here is hunching. This one. You just see. It's a hunching. So now, and second point is, the advantages of a hunching alone is that it gives no indications at the actual height, and that both high plateau region and low plains are unshaded. And third is, the close hatcherings of the high mountain region tends to obscure other details of the map. Second, hill shading. Hill shading shown the relief by height and shade. Two methods adopted. This first one, a light is imaged to be vertical over the area being mapped. The steep slope are then shown by the dark shading and the level ground, whether high or low, are unshaded. And B point is, a light is imagined to be shining from the southeast, so that northwest facing slope and are more darkly shaded than those facing south and east. You can see over here in this picture is hilly shading. Both the methods give a general idea to relief of the country, but the advantages are similar to those of hunching, with that hill shading does not give any idea of actual height, and that is a difficult to know whether a piece of land is slope, uphill or downhill. And third is form line. Form line are contour lines, but show only approximate heights above sea level, as they are used to indicate the elevation of the area, which are not accessible for proper survey. Hence they are drawn as broken line, are they called form lines. You just see over there. एंड यू जस्ट सी इट्स अ फॉर्म लाइन ब्रोकन ओवर देयर, ये जो लाइन जो ब्रोक कर रही है दैट इज कॉल्ड. एंड द फोर्थ पॉइंट इज द स्पॉट हाइट. लुक एट द सैम्पल सर्वे मैप विच शोन अ नंबर ऑफ डॉट्स विच अ नंबर बिसाइड देम denoting height of that point above mean sea level. For example, the height of place is 60 meters, so written by as 60 degree, 16. So this one, it says spot height. Okay. So now we are continuing this lesson in next video. Thank you.